Yellowstone National Park, visited by millions of people the world over, remains one of the finest, most complete wildlands on Earth. Most visitors to the park come during the summer to enjoy the menagerie that is Yellowstone. The large and small animals that have been native to the Rocky Mountains for thousands of years. Breathtaking landscapes. Skyrocketing geysers. And cascading waterfalls. Yet there is another side to Yellowstone Park that most visitors never see. A landscape of majestic beauty, bitter cold, and extreme danger. A land where endurance is the game and survival is the prize. Winter is Yellowstone's longest season. It's a world unlike any other. Powerful, brutal, beautiful, and enchanting. It's a season both abstract and profound, and where silence and solitude dominate the park's wilderness. The deafening silence of Yellowstone in winter represents the strength of endurance, the power of patience, the grace of waiting, and the triumph of survival. Our world of the 21st century is a noisy, busy place, but in the splendid, silent winter of Yellowstone, it's possible to discover a peace and solitude that will refresh your spirit and lift your soul. All the movements and sounds of the land, the weather, the wildlife, are muffled under winter's majesty. Yellowstone seasons each sing magnificently, but Yellowstone's winter is the purest, quietest chorus of them all.
Production of Silence and Solitude, Yellowstone's Winter Wilderness was made possible by the University of Montana, where the discovery continues, and by the contributing members who make up the Friends of Montana PBS, and by viewers like you who watch and support public television. Thank you.
Before winter cascades down from the north, Mother Nature prepares Yellowstone for what's to come. Autumn is the most comfortable season for Yellowstone's inhabitants. The healthy animals are all eating to store enough fat to survive the winter. The weather is warm in the day and pleasantly cool at night. Most of the birds have migrated south, leaving the sky nearly empty and quiet. The animals sense a change in the air and in their lives. The first snows of winter add valuable moisture to Yellowstone. As the weather turns cool, the land seems to gently and quietly relax. Thermal features become more visible. White puffs and plumes of steam rise in new places as the air grows colder. Animals prepare for winter by growing a thick extra coat. They migrate to areas where food will be more plentiful during the upcoming winter.
Thank you.
winter is the best time to observe Yellowstone's thermal features. The interaction between boiling water and sub-zero air creates a mystical world of clouds, fog, and frost. Yellowstone has become one of the world's premier wildlife preserves. Geothermal activity draws wildlife in winter, just as a crackling, glowing campfire draws us. Bison and elk seek out warm ground to sleep on, and it's common to see them standing right in the steam clouds when the temperature plummets. Thank you. No animal typifies Yellowstone's winter better than the American bison. Yellowstone is the only place in the lower 48 states where a population of wild bison has persisted since prehistoric times. They exude the power and patience required to survive and thrive in this harsh environment. Bison move carefully and conservatively. They move the snow with their massive heads, powered by the muscles on their humps. Their beards help to brush the fine crystals off the grass, and their thick, dark hair is an efficient insulator. Bison can be seen in the bitter cold, covered with frost and snow. They may look frozen, but it's really a testament to how well their thick hair insulates them. Their body heat doesn't escape past the hair to melt the frost and ice. The dark hair also absorbs heat from the weak winter sun and aids in their energy needs. Bison have a magnificent winter cape that covers their head, neck, shoulders, sides, and front legs, including the wonderful set of chaps on the back of their front legs. To survive the winter, they must push snow away to eat. They push it away to walk, and they push it away even to lie down. If the snow gets too deep or the surface too hard and crusty, they can't push it enough to keep up their energy. The strongest ones have enough fat reserves to survive until spring. But the weakest ones will live only if the winter happens to be mild and short. Winter is ultimately the season that controls Yellowstone's wildlife populations with a calm, indifferent, and unforgiving certainty. There is a slow, deliberate seriousness in what the animals do in the winter. There is very little playfulness. A protective stillness envelops them. Even the calmness of their breathing becomes noticeable. Animals must endure not only the cold, but also intense winds. Some seek refuge in the trees, but when travel is necessary in open places, they must push headstrong into the wind or be pushed by the wind. Endurance is everything. Winter in Yellowstone is a powerful time. It measures and controls the health of this land just as Mother Nature intended. Winter is the fulcrum on which all other seasons balance. The beauty of this land is polished by wind, ice, and cold. Yet it yields a landscape that is soft and rounded by snow. The simplicity and clarity of Yellowstone's beauty is at its very best during winter. Winter begins to relax its hold on the land as the sun moves north. Days feel warmer. The light lasts longer. The small snow crystals begin to melt and reform into larger crystals. The melting snow soaks into the awakening earth and gently revives the seeds from the previous summer. Maternal instincts are rekindled as animals welcome another generation to the Yellowstone family. The circle of life begins again. Yellowstone National Park is one of those very special places on Earth that can send our spirits soaring with its inspiring beauty. We need places like Yellowstone for the health of our own spirit, for the way it sustains life, freedom, and beauty, for the way it connects us to our past and for the way it will connect future generations to us. For what Yellowstone has given us, we have an obligation to give back in kind. So even if we never have the opportunity to visit Yellowstone National Park, we owe it to ourselves to do all we can to preserve this splendid place we call simply Yellowstone.
Production of Silence and Solitude, Yellowstone's Winter Wilderness, was made possible by the University of Montana, where the discovery continues, and by the contributing members who make up the Friends of Montana PBS, and by viewers like you who watch and support public television. Thank you.